Hi guys, welcome back. TerraFirmaCraft with me, Sid, and I've got a few plans for today. Nothing majorly exciting, but I think it'll be fun. So let's start off by going and seeing what I've done on the castle, because I've continued working on it between episodes, and I've just been putting in this little roadway area to come up here, and I'm just getting to get the right mode. Bonk 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 bonk. I'm just putting some steps in for this to 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Suppose I could vary these a little bit just to make them look a little bit less uniform. It might be something to do in the not too distant future. But fortunately, this basalt's fairly common, so and finally this lot. Okay, so let's step back and let me show you. So I've got a tower at that side done. I've put inverted steps underneath. We've got the walls done here, and on the back here. So it's starting to take shape. It is taking an absolute age, and it's taking an absolute metric crap ton of material, as you can imagine. So a couple of things I am going to need a lot of, and one of them is obviously this stone, which I've got up there, but it's a bit of a hike to get up there. The other thing I am going to need is sand for the mortar, but that's another thing. So now, one of the suggestions when I've talked about buildings was to actually build a moonshining hut, or whiskey kind of smuggling hut kind of thing, prohibition styley, up in the hills. And it occurred to me that that might be an ideal kind of midway location to work. I'm going the wrong way. Shouldn't do that. Midway location, just to have a little hut instead of living in that hovel of a cave that we've got. Oh, hello gold. I'll leave you there, that way I'll find you easier when I want you. So that's what I intend to do today, is to up on that, you can see where those trees are up there. I think we'll put it in that those trees. There's plenty of, I mean, I brought some birch and aspen, but there's also quite a lot of these down here, so I've equipped myself with quite a lot of tools, so we can hopefully get, I'm not even sure what tree this is, to be honest, but it's a white cedar, so that gives us some white cedar logs. Might as well chop it down now I've got it. I've got those saplings, so I'm not too worried about that. Ooh, hello. You got some more, have you? And the other ones that I quite as take, I'm not, again, not sure what these are. But it's nice to have a little bit of variety. There we go. What are you? Pine. Let's have that down then. And I'll just use this scythe for as long as I've got a scythe, and as long as I've got a few saplings of this, then it'll be useful to have. What are you? Hematite. Anyway, so first thing I need to do is just get up there and plot out roughly where I want to build the hut, and I've got some sugar canes with me, so we are good. How did I get up there then? Oh, I did it. So no damn stinking feds are going to find this place. We're going to be nice up in the country, well out of the way, hidden from all prying eyes. That's the plan. I'm probably going to need to go and get that bed from the cave just to so I can sleep the night off, because I'm not going to get this built in one night, and I'm not even going to get it. That looks like platinum. I don't think I'm going to get it built in 2 or 3 nights, so, you know, I need to make it fairly mob-proof. I also need to find an easier way to get up here. But, yeah, that's the plan. A little bit of building. Probably doing a fair amount of chiseling. Now, somewhere about, I should be able to see. It's over here somewhere. My torch, there we go. That's where we want to be. Torch indicates the entrance. Got my water barrel. Got my bed and just a little bit of that. So we'll go grab that and we'll grab the water barrel for now. And that's not it. We'll add the chest as well. Not bothered about the dirt. My food situation is not brilliant. Most of that food that I made in early summer is practically decayed already. I haven't looked in the cellar. That's the one place I haven't checked out. Let me try and do this without killing myself. Oh God, the bloody sheep scared the crap out of me. So, nope. You want me, Mr. Skeleton? You can come get me. I see ya. Let's just eat this. I'm wondering if we can... That was a sheep, wasn't it? I'm wondering if we can make this spawn area fairly safe. And the answer is probably going to be yes, with a bit of luck. If I knock that out, though, oh God, how am I going to do this? I need it to make it so there's no overhangs big enough for anything to spawn on. Have I got any planks on me? I have. Let me switch in there a little bit, and then we'll try and find, so there's no overhang here, but there's quite an overhang here, because obviously we don't want any unwelcome neighbours. Creeping up on us. And this will just mean that there's no spawnable spots on this cliffside. I'm going to have to get myself dug in somewhere safe. I've left it too long. Right, I'm going to just go down here. I think I spotted a likely spot where I could dig in. And I will see you in the morning. Okay, so I'm thinking around about here. I've just taken out a tree in this area. I've got no idea what I just picked up. So I'm thinking what we will do is grab a little bit of dirt just to fill in. I need some more. Give me more dirt. Where can I steal some dirt from which will not be too horrible on the landscape? We'll have you. And some of this. That should probably be enough, I think. No need a huge amount. It's not going to be a massive construction, this. It's just going to be like a little shack up in the mountains. A little shack up in the mountains. So I'll probably use the entire area here. And what I am thinking, I've got plenty of birch, not much pine on me at the moment, so I'm thinking we'll probably go one, two, three, about there, maybe. Not very big, is it? Could go back one. Let me just pop you down, and so going here and here. And then from there, that will be, these will be like raised stilts, and then we'll come 1, 2, 3, 4. Hup. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, this is going to hurt a lot if I carry on at this rate. 1, 2, 2, 3. I'll deal with number 4 later. I think that might be the better way. 1, 2, 3. Right, now what do we want to do for the floor? Aspen, maybe? It's quite a nice dark texture. Ugh, missed. And at this stage, I am just going to build it as I would any other normal Minecraft building. That's probably, yeah, thinking about it. What about birch? Let me just try something. Birch. So if I, instead of, if I make the walls out of aspen planks. Ah! Got it. So you get some kind of contrasting colour. And then if I make, oh, how am I going to do this? My inventory is such a mess, it's untrue. If I get you and then get my birch planks here and make you, don't want you that way around. I'm thinking of making the floor actually out of planks. I think that might give us a thin floor which we can it's actually less effective than using these, but it's actually more realistic, if that makes it for a given value of realistic, because you know nobody has 1 meter thick floorboards. It's just not done. I can vary them as well like that, can't I? Dirt, 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 dirt. And then, yeah. So I'm going to get this floor in and I'm going to put a little balcony area out here, which is going to be, again, raised up on stilts like that. And I will be right back with you. Okay, quick update. Ta-da! It's a box with a plank. I've run out of, what was this, birch, wasn't it? Yeah, run out of birch. So I need to go back and grab some more, but you can see the kind of thing we're going for. Now, this I am going to, let me just go and grab this little bugger and go mode. What we're going to do is we're going to actually make the walls, that's three, thinner. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And there's my first problem. I need to obviously fill in underneath there. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And yeah, so we're going to actually have these quite a bit thinner. Because one of the things I always dislike with especially small builds is the fact that the walls are always a uniform 1 meter thick. And obviously on a hut this small, 1 meter, I mean, this is still probably a little bit too thick here. But on a hut this small, it is really obvious. You know, you've got this huge space. Well, something for a very small space, but, you know, probably 50% of it, or within that region, 40% of it is actually made up by these huge solid walls, and it just always seems really odd to me that we have that kind of thing going on. Now, what I'm thinking with these support pillars at the side is to go in that way and that way, so they jut out a little bit, but not all the way. And hopefully this will look just a little bit more organic in nature. Anyway, I need to squiz off and grab some more birch. I'll probably try and grab some pine, and I'll leave some of this stuff up here while I'm at it. And I will be back once I've got a little bit more progress to show you. So, see you soon. Okay, I've done. I'll show you that down there in a moment. But I was hoping to use planks for the roof, but I don't think I'm going to get away with it because you can't merge the wood types, which is a shame. So I've got a couple of options. One is I can either go in stair mode, you know, good old tried and tested. And I'm using pine because there's quite a lot of pine down there. And obviously this will work pretty fine. You know, there's no real problems with using steps as a roofing material, because obviously that's what we do in vanilla Minecraft all the time. The other way, which would be far more chisel intensive, and consequently I'm a little bit reluctant to let me get back into slab mode. 2, 3, 4. Now, do I want to do it? Let's do it like that, I think. We'll make it so that they're not just pure half slabs. Would be to go into detail mode and chisel each chunk out until I got a nice triangular roof, which I'm really not inclined to do for this build. If it was a bigger build somewhere else, maybe, but you know, it would be a right royal pain in the backside to do. So, down here, let me just take out my supports there. Fairly straightforward, simple shack. The walls are obviously thinner. And then we've got the little porch area. Now, the way I want to go here is coming out. Oh, it's getting night time. Maybe the way I want to go here is go to sleep. But I want a kind of little porch area coming out underneath here, and yeah, And then it's on to a bit more detail, I think, but night time, so we really ought to get a little bit of shut-eye before the mobs come. Oh, look at that, X-ray vision. And call me paranoid, but my first action when I come out of here is to just run for some clear area so I can see what the hell's going on. That's just my way. So, yeah, taking our pine planks, we've got a fair amount of pine left anyway. We can, now I'm thinking to bring it out here and maybe... No, I don't like that. No. No. What we will... Oh, hang on. Oh, God, here we go. Runaway planks. Let me get some of that on the hot bar. And we will... Come out and just bring that down. I'd like, rather have it... Hang on. So if I started go the right way round, damn you. Hang on. Well, if I start with my roof where? No. These planks fly, they're as bad as paintings. If I kind of come here and go like that, and then come down and then go two, and then down and then two, and then down and then two. Yeah, that works. And then I can put another block here and we can go down, 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 and down. That might work. So, fiddly detail yet again. I think I'm becoming a martyr to microblock construction. Because whenever the opportunity arrives, I seem to end up doing it. And then... Because that's still well under there. Let's just... grab those back. How does... You are joking, aren't you? Obviously not. Where are you? Thank you. So the idea here will be that we've got this comes down, and then if I grab some more birch planks, we can take this up a little. Now I don't know, and I'm fairly certain this won't work. This is where the problem, of course. Yeah. Oh. All right. Prove me a liar. Let's try and just work our way in here then. And then around here, I don't mind the fact that that's kind of poking up through it, because it's supposed to be kind of a rusty construction. So that's giving us the porch area. I'll get that finished. I'm going to need to go and grab some sand for some glass from somewhere and get that cooked. And doors... and so on and so forth. And I'll probably need to get some barrels and fill them with water as well. So I'm going to continue just building this little porch area. It helps if you do it with the right material. And I'll go and get some barrels made, filled with water, bring them up, and we can get... Oh, and some glass so we can make the doors, and we'll have our little... moonshine cabin, so, well, rum cabin to be strictly speaking accurate, sorted. before you know it. So I'll be back in a moment. Okay, I think we're about ready to have a go at making some rum. It'll not be ready this episode, but let me show you the final building. Still not 100% happy with that. Now, one thing I did play around with doing, and let me know what you think, is giving this a bit of texture with the old chisel. It is painstakingly slow. Where's my hammer? Oh crap, where's put my hammer? Put my hammer somewhere. Hammer. Oh god, only knows what I've done with that. Is not a problem, however. Because we have rock. And when we have rock, we have tools. Is it that? Yes. It's a while since I had to make one that this way. Yeah, so you got my hammer. And as I say, this is a right royal pain in the bum to do. So I'm kind of six to one, half a dozen to the whether we should actually do this, because you basically give it this little bit of a texture, almost as if it's kind of logs rather than just flat planks. So I'm not sure. And the other thing I thought about doing is we could round these off a bit as well, and don't worry, I'm not proposing to do this all on camera, because as I say, it's a bit of a ball ache to say the least. And it's a bit of a chisel hog as well, because it's going to basically eat so much chisel away just taking these little nooks out. Ah! And sometimes we screw up like that, but it doesn't matter. It gives it a little bit of character, i.e. I ain't fixing it. I don't even know whether I've got any planks of that left. So I mean, you know, wood blocks of that left. But so that might look, let me just do the same here quickly. I'll not do the inside because you'll not be able to see it, so at least that's one saving grace. It is so finicky though, if you just miss even the slightest thing, you can have a slice out, I suppose, not unlike a real chisel. So that's an option that I may do. Let me know what you think about that. Now, rum, I've got two barrels down here. I've got a barrel there, and I've got three barrels in here at the moment. So you take sugar. I'm not entirely sure how much you put in, so I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. And seal that. Oop. And seal. And seal. And leave that a while and it'll turn into rum. If we seal that again, it'll turn into vinegar. And the vinegar is what we need to turn the milk into cheese. So, yeah, this is my little shack on the hill here. I will probably just go and plant a couple of these too. I will probably go and throw a couple of these on the ground wildly with abandon, just to hide the it from the feds. You know, we don't want people coming and telling us we can't make room up in our mountain little shack. And where this is really handy is, oh, I put a window in there because I've chiseled these, glass panes won't go in there. I brought one back from the house. I've popped off down there to have a look. But yeah, I'm happy. I'm quite happy with that. That's our little mountain shack. And as I say, it's got the advantage that it is fairly close to the area that we're quarrying the dolomite and shale from, which is of course up here. Once we can get up there, we'll get there eventually. Oh man, or maybe not. How did I get up this bloody thing? Every time I try to come up here, I'm like, how did I get up? That's not what it. Don't think I'm going to make that. No. And. Need to probably put a better route in, but obviously then we can get up here quite easily and continue cutting away at this stuff, get the dark stone. And it's a lot easier to find than our stupid cave there, because you can see it from up here. So, yeah, very easy just to trundle on down and get back to go to sleep. So yeah, I'm happy enough with that. I think it's a nice little place. It's winter's, by the way, is coming on. We're on the 3rd of December now, so we're definitely into, what's this, our third year now? I think it may be our third year. But yeah, we have a little shack in the mountains for making our rum. And as I say, as soon as this is done, I've got 9 bottles already. So, once again, guys, thank you very much for watching. Do let me know about what you think about detailing the cabin, whether we should go and start chiseling and finagling, whatever you want to call it. This build any more, making it, I think, you know what, I still want to do that. Yeah, so do let us know what you think. Any suggestions, gratefully received. And as usual, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye for now.